So for my preset, it doesn't matter as a PT where you start. And I'm very systematic because I always start at the feet and I ask myself questions. So the first thing is I look at the feet and I say to myself, okay, what is her base of support in contact with the ground? Does she have a wide base of support? Are her feet directly underneath her knees? Or are her feet outside of her knees? So, you know, I'm just looking at that base of support and I start at the ground up. So when I'm looking at it like that, if her knees, you know, are her tibias in vertical, if her base of support is wide, okay, wider than her knees, okay, so that's going to tell me what? If I see that her feet are, you could position like that, what is that going to tell you? Like, she's got a widened base of support, okay, but her knees are kind of inward. So I'm thinking, all right, well, potentially she could have some sitting balance issues. She's trying to widen her base of support. So I'm just thinking about that. She's got a wider base of support. And then as I'm moving up, I'm looking at the knees. And her knees, in this position, I'm saying, well, looks like there's some genuvalgum. I'm starting to see some genuvalgum. I look at the patellas to see, okay, because the knees are the eyes of the hips. And I'm looking to see, okay, because I'm in the sagittal plane, I'm looking to see, are her her hips in adduction or abduction? So you look at the aorta and coming down, and she looks like she's in a little bit of adduction. And that makes sense, because she's got a wider base of support, looks like she has some genuvalgum, and she looks like her hips are in a little bit of adduction. Okay? Now, if she has internal rotation of her hips, so that occurs in the transverse plane, we're going to see that here too. So she looks like she also has a little bit of internal rotation of the hips. Okay, so then moving up, I'm looking to see where her trunk is. So is she in midline, or does she have a listing or a lean to one side of her for her trunk? And she looks nice. She looks like there's not a lean to either to the right or the left. Okay. Then moving up more, I look at, you know, where are her hands? Are her hands out to the side in weight bearing? Or they're on her lap? So I would just take note of that. Okay. And then I look to see, is one shoulder higher than another? And it looks like her right shoulder is slightly lower than the left. And she looks like she has a little bit of right side bending in the circle, like her head is tilted a little bit to her right. Okay, so now I'm going to come to the side here. When I'm on the side, I'm looking at sagittal plane. So I'm starting at the ankles, and I'm like, okay, is she in plantar flexion? Is she in dorsiflexion? And I can use the tibia as the an indicator of that. If the tibia is vertical, okay, that will tell me, okay, it looks like the foot is completely flat in contact. Actually, her foot is a little bit forward. She actually looks like she's plantar flexed a little bit there. Okay, so then I go up to the chain and I'm looking at the knee angle. How much knee flexion or extension? Does it look like she's in greater than 90 degrees or less than 90 degrees? Actually, it's less than 90 degrees, I'm sorry, less than 90 degrees. And so, because what I'm doing is I'm looking at her femurs. Her femur is not parallel to the ground. So her femur, her knees are lower than her hips. So what does that tell you in terms of mechanical advantage or disadvantage?
Advantage.
She has an advantage, so it should be easier for her. I look at the hips, her hips and her trunk, and she looks like she's at 90. Okay? And if you could put your hair behind your ears, because now I want to look at your shoulders. And I look at the shoulders, and from the side, if she has thoracic rotation or rotation of her trunk, you can usually see that, because you'll be able to. So I'm just looking. It looks as though her acromion is anterior to her external mediatus, so she does have some rounded shoulders, so I'm thinking her pec might be a little bit tight, and she might have some scapular protraction, but I'm going to go behind in a moment to check on that. Okay? And looking at her shoulder to her ears, she does have a little bit of forehead, but she looks good, actually. She does look good.
So from behind, okay, what I do is, again, I look to see, is her head, like, in midline?
I'm looking to see, does it look like she's weight-bearing on one side or another? And I'm just going to roll this up a little bit, okay? So you can see sometimes if somebody, can you exaggerate, like if you were to lean it back, like she would have potentially more of a skin fold on one side, okay? And you would be able to see it a little bit easier if there was more weight-bearing on towards one side or another based on a skin fold, or if they had a scoliosis in their spine. So coming up, I will come in, I'll look at the iliac crest. That'll help, okay? And then I'm looking at the lumbar spine. I can see from the back, you know, on the side, when I'm on the side, I will see the pelvic rotation, if they're in a posterior tilt or anterior tilt, and I didn't say that before, so I apologize for that. When I go to the back, we're going to be able to see that more, where, you know, if she's sitting more on her sacrum or not. And then I go up and I really take a look at the scapular position, okay? So I palpate the inferior angles of the scap and I go to the midline of the thoracic spine, okay? And I do a comparison from one side to another to look at to see if one is more protracted than another or more retracted, and if there's an upward rotation or not. And if I needed to, I could take a measurement. Okay, so that is the preset. So because I know this is a primarily sagittal plane motion, I'm gonna be positioned here. So what I'd like to have you do is you can keep your hands there just like you had them in the preset.
What you do now is, can you demonstrate for me how you would stand up?
Good, and then sit back down. So what's the very first question I want to ask myself?
How did she initiate?
So where, what is she, how is she initiating? What is moving first? Let's just see how she goes again. Good. And come back down. And go ahead. And come back down. So What did you see move first? So we see a little bit of movement in our hands first. So our hands start to come forward a little bit. And then so then she goes into, let's try to stay consistent with joint motion. Let's just say, so we're seeing some hip flexion, close chain hip flexion. You don't need to say close chain, just say we're seeing some hip flexion. So first thing we see move is her hand. So go ahead. So we see our hands go into a little bit of what? Flexion. Then we see some shoulder, some hip flexion, but we're seeing the hip flexion because her shoulders are coming forward. So her hands move forward, her shoulders come forward. Go ahead, back down. So it's hands, shoulders, and then what did you see next? What I see next is I see her femur start to translate forward. And why do I see that? What's happening? She's unweighting her bottom. So she's starting to get to that pivot point. So we start to see the femurs and the tibias translate forward. And that's causing her to go into more dorsiflexion. And then once she unweights and her bottom comes off, right, then we start to see knee extension and then finally trunk extension. So let's have you go down. So when you, go ahead, have a seat back down. When you guys are doing this, the first thing you want to do is just identify what you're, just say, okay, I see her hands moving, I see the shoulders moving second, then I'm seeing her femurs moving, her tibias, then I'm starting to see her knees start to go into a little bit of extension. And then I'm starting to see her trunk go into extension. Then, so this is like the framework because it's going so quickly. Then you're going to say, okay, then it's, I'm seeing some shoulder flexion. That makes sense? Shoulder flexion, hip flexion. Then you start to see the femurs coming forward in the sagittal plane. Then you start to see the unfolding, so her knees start to go into extension, her hips start to go into extension, and then you see elbow extension. And that's exactly, that's the movement analysis for sit to stand. Competency, I would say, well, how would you, what would be a descriptor? What type of movement is this?
It's a serial motion.
Yes. And what other qualities could you potentially describe how she's moving?
Smooth.
Mm-hmm.
Coordinated.
So as coordinated, I'd stay probably away from. But as she starts to move it, her speed of the motion is consistent throughout the phases.